Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Phalo. A congregation in Nashua is looking for a place to call home after a weekend fire. It happened during Sunday services at Heritage Baptist Church. No one was hurt, but cleanup is going to take some time. And as Ray Brewer reports, the pastor says he doesn't know where he'll be able to carry on his ministry. I got it.
A day and a half after fire tore through the attic of the Heritage Baptist Church in Nashua, cleanup continued. There were more than 60 people attending Sunday evening services when the fire broke out. Everyone made it out safely, but the damage was extensive.
Within probably 4 or 5 hours, what was once a beautiful, clean church, air-conditioned church, became a war zone.
But in the midst of that war zone, a minor miracle.
The firemen came out. I don't know how he even knew who I was and brought me the Bible, my Bible, from the pulpit in pristine condition.
Pastor Heilman says when it first happened, it was tough not to get discouraged, but the support from other congregations has given him hope.
Pastors have all contacted me, an incredible camaraderie of brotherhood, and it's impressive.
And the city is also pitching in to see if there's anything they can do. Mayor Donnelly Lozo stopping by to see if there was any assistance the city can provide.
I just wanted them to know that the city was keeping an eye on them and that we were here if there was something we could do to help.
The pastor says right now the biggest challenge is finding some place to continue the ministry, but he has faith that a solution will be found.
At this point, it's believed that an electrical problem is to blame. Well, funeral services are being held today for the Plaistow Police Chief, Steve Savage. He passed away last week after a long battle with kidney cancer. Savage was Plaistow's longest-serving chief, leading the force for 28 years. Friends and family describe him as a man who loved his community, always looking for ways to help those in need.
He was a true, dedicated employee. Through all the diagnosis, he came to work every day. He didn't skip a beat.
Savage also served in Vietnam, and after today's services, he will be buried with Air Force honors. Chief Stephen Savage was 68 years old. We're waiting to hear the identity of a man who drowned yesterday in Guilford. Lifeguards found the man yesterday at seven feet of water on Lake Winnipesaukee off the shore of Eloquoia State Park. They tried CPR, but he later died at the hospital. An autopsy is expected today. The demolition of an apartment building in Lowell, Mass., where 7 people were killed, has now been postponed. Crews were supposed to tear down the building today, but family members of the victims filed a motion to hold the demolition until investigators determine what caused the deadly blaze. We're expected to hear more details later this afternoon. And we have some great news about Boston bombing survivor Jeff Bowman. The New Hampshire native's book, Stronger, is heading now to the big screen. Lionsgate Entertainment announced plans to turn Bowman's story of strength and perseverance into a movie. Just yesterday, Bowman announced that he and his fiancée are now parents to a baby girl named Nora. Well, starting tonight at 5 o'clock, strangers at a shopping plaza see kids in a hot car. Wait until you see what they did to get them out. And Facebook hopes to change TV ratings. Who will tell about your viewing habits online? That does it for us. Thanks for joining us and have a great afternoon.